Hi, hello guys, welcome to the IAS Coaching Channel, and let's start with our new topic, Ramsar Sites in India. Ramsar Sites, what is Ramsar Sites? A convention related to wetlands held in Ramsar city of Iran in 1971. So they named it as Ramsar Convention. Ramsar Sites in India comprises Indian wetlands deemed to be of international importance under the Ramsar Convention. The Ramsar Convention held in 1971 in Ramsar city, Iran. There are total 27 Ramsar sites in India. Let's start with first Ramsar site. Ashtamudi Wetland, Kerala. A natural black water in the Kollam district of Kerala. River Kallada and Palichal drains into it. It forms an estuary with sea at Nindakaral, which is famous fishing harbor in the Kerala. A national waterway 3 passes through it. The most tastiest black water fish in the Kerala, the Karimeen of Kanjirikode Kayal, is from Ashtamudi Lake. 2. Bhitarkanika Mangroves, Odisha. The core area of the sanctuary, with the area of 147 square kilometers, was declared as Bhitarkanika National Park in September 1998. Gari Mata Marine Wildlife Sanctuary, which bounds the Bhitarkanika Wildlife Sanctuary to the east. In the east of Bhitarkanika Wildlife Sanctuary, there is Marine Wildlife Sanctuary called as Gahir Mata, was created in September 1997, and the encompass Gahir Mata Beach and adjacent portion of Bay of Bengal. The Bhitarkanika mangroves were designated a Ramsar wetland of international importance in 2002. It is famous for its saltwater crocodile and olive ridley sea turtles. 3. Bhoj Wetlands, Madhya Pradesh. The Bhoj wetland consists of two lakes located in the city of Bhopal. The two lakes are Bhojtal and Lower Lake. It is man-made reservoir and total of more than 20,000 birds are observed annually. Bhoj wetland was recognized as wetland of international importance under Ramsar Convention of 1971 in 2002. The white storks, black-necked storks, bar-headed geese, spoonbills, etc. have started appearing. A recent phenomenon is the gathering of 100 to 120 Saurus cranes in the lake. The largest bird of India, the Saurus crane, is known for its size, majestic flight and lifetime pairing. So these Saurus cranes have started gathering in Bhoj wetlands. 4th, Chandra Tal, Himachal Pradesh. A high altitude lake on upper Chandra valley falling to the Chandra river of western Himalayas. Near the Kunjum Pass, please remember Kunjum Pass, joining the Himalayan and Pir Panjal ranges. It supports status and IUCN red listed snow leopard and is a refuge for many species like snow, cock and choker, black ringslet and kestrel, golden eagle and crow, red fox, Himalayan ibex and blue sheep. 5th one, Chilka Lake, Odisha. Chilka Lake is a brackish water lagoon. It is the largest coastal lagoon in India. Please remember, Chilka Lake is the largest coastal lagoon in India and second largest lagoon in the world. The lagoon hosts over 160 species of bird in a peak migratory season. The birds from as far as the Caspian Sea, Lake Baikal, Aral Sea and other remote parts of Russia, Kyrgyz Steppe Sea of Mongolia and Central and Southeast Asia, Ladakh and Himalayas comes here. In 1981, Chilka Lake was designated the first wetland of international importance under the Ramsar Convention in 1971. The Irrawaddy Dolphins is a flagship species of Chilka Lake. The Chilka is home to the only known population of Irrawaddy Dolphins in India. and one of the two lagoons in the world that are home to this species. Sixth one, Dibor Bel, Assam, a permanent freshwater lake in the form of channel of the Brahmaputra River, of the great biological importance and also essential as the only major storm water storage basin for the city of Guwahati. The Bel is staging site on migratory flyways, and some of the largest concentration of aquatic birds in Assam can be seen, especially in winter. Seventh one, East Kolkata Wetlands, West Bengal. The wetland forms an urban facility for treating the city wastewater and utilizing the treated water for pisciculture and agriculture. Through the recovery of nutrients in an efficient manner, the water flows through the fish ponds covering about 4000 hectares, and the ponds act as solar reactors and complete most of their biochemical reactions with help of solar energy. Thus, the system is described as one of the rare examples of the environmental protection and development management where a complex ecological process have been adopted by the local farmers for mastering the resource recovery activities. 8th one, Harike Wetlands, Punjab, a shallow water reservoir with the 13 islands at the confluence of two rivers. Dense floating vegetation covers 70% of lake. An important site for breeding, wintering and staging birds supporting over 2 lakhs antidae, that is ducks, geese, swans during the migration. The entire lake is leased on an annual basis to the commercial fishery organization. Pokhara Wetlands, Jammu and Kashmir, located in northwestern Himalayan biogeographical province of Kashmir, back of the snow-draped Pir Panchal. Pokhara Wetland is only 10 kilometers from the scenic paradise of Srinagar. A natural perennial wetland continuous to the Juhum Basin. It is the only site with remaining reed beds of Kashmir and pathway of 68 waterfall species like large egret, great crested grebe, little cormorant and common shell duck and tuff duck and endangered white-eyed poacher coming from Siberia, China, Central Asia and Northern Europe. 10th one, Kanjli Wetlands, Punjab, a permanent stream, the Kali Bin, converted by the construction of small barrage in 1870 into a water storage area for irrigation purposes. The site fulfills the criteria 3. So there are three criteria. Under the criteria 3, the Kanjli Wetlands fulfills the Ramsar Convention rules because of its importance in supporting a considerable diversity of aquatic, mesophytic and terrestrial flora and fauna in biogeographical region, and act also as a key regulator of groundwater discharge and recharge with the season. The stream is considered to be the most significant in the state from the religious point of view, as it is associated with first guru of Sikhs, Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji. The stream itself and surrounding the marsh is under provisional ownership and surrounding areas privately owned. The site is center for environment, tourism and picnicking. 11. Keoladio National Park, Rajasthan, a complex of 10 artificial seasonal lagoons varying in size situated in densely populated region. The vegetation is a mosaic of scrubs and open grasslands that provides the habitat for the breeding, wintering and staging migratory birds. Also supported are 5 species of ungulates, 4 species of cats and 2 species of primates, as well as diverse plants and fish, reptiles. 12th, Kolleru Lake, Andhra Pradesh, bird sanctuary and an artificial freshwater lake. Koller Lake is one of the largest freshwater lakes in India, located in the state of Andhra Pradesh, and forms the largest shallow freshwater lake in Asia. Loktak Lake, Manipur. Loktak Lake is the largest freshwater lake in the northeastern region of the country, which is famous for the humdis, that is heterogeneous mass of vegetation, soil and organic matter at various stages of decomposition. The floating over it, the humdis, which comprises of mass of vegetation, soil, organic matters at different stages of decomposition, will be floating over it. The Kilbul Lamjau, the only floating national park in the world, floats over it. So, the national park Kilbul Lamjau floats over the Loktak Lake. 14. Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary, Gujarat. A natural freshwater lake that is the largest natural wetland in the Thar Desert biogeographical provinces and represents a dynamic environment with salinity and depth varying depending on rainfall. It is an important stopover site within the Central Asia flyway, with globally threatened species such as critically endangered sociable lapwing and the vulnerable marbled teal stopping over at sites during the migration. So there are some critically endangered species like sociable lapwing and marbled teal stop at this Nalsar Bird Sanctuary during the migration. The wetland is also a lifeline for the satellite population of endangered Indian wild ass, which uses this area in the dry season. 15th one. Point Kalimere Wildlife and Bird Sanctuary, Tamil Nadu. One of the last remnants of dry evergreen forests. 16. Pong Dam Lake, Himachal Pradesh. A water storage reservoir created in 1975 on the Bias River in the low foothills of Himalaya, on the northern edge of Indo-Gangetic Plain. 17th one. Renuka Lake, Himachal Pradesh. A natural wetland with freshwater springs and inland subterranean crust formation fed by small streams flowing from the lower Himalayan out to the Giri River. The lake has high religious significance and is named after the mother of Hindu sage Parshuram and is thus visited by the thousands of pilgrims and tourists. 18th one. Rupar Wetlands, Punjab. A human-made wetland of lake and river formed by the 1952 by the construction of barrage for the diversion of water from the Satluj River for drinking and irrigation supplies. The site is an important breeding place for the nationally protected. Please remember, this is an important site for breeding of nationally protected smooth Indian otter, hawk deer, sambar and several reptiles and the endangered Indian pangolin is thought to be present. So it is a most important breeding place for the nationally protected smooth Indian otter, hawk deer, sambar and endangered Indian pangolin. 19th. Rudrasagar Lake, Tripura. Rudrasagar Lake is also known as Rudijal, and the lake is located in Melagar, Tripura. 20. Sambar Lake, Rajasthan. The Sambar Lake, the India's largest inland salt lake. Sambar has been designated as Ramsar site because the wetland is a key wintering area for tens of thousands of flamingos and other birds that migrate from the North Asia. The specialized algae and bacteria growing in the lake provide striking water colors and support the lake ecology that in turn sustain the migrating waterfall. 21. Sastamkota Lake, Kerala. It is the largest freshwater lake in the Kerala. Situated in Kollam district, the river Kalada had unique replenishing system through bar of paddy fields which has now disappeared due to the indiscriminate sand and clay mining. The lake is now depleting due to the destruction of replenishing mechanism. 22. Sorinsar Mansar Lakes, Jammu and Kashmir. The freshwater composite lake in semi-arid Punjab plains adjoining the Juhu basin with a catchment of sandy conglomeratic soil, boulders and pebbles. Sorinsar is a rain fed without permanent discharge and Mansar is a primary fed by the surface runoff and partially by the mineralized water through the paddy fields with inflow increasing in rainy season. So there are two lakes, Sorinsar and Mansar. The Sorinsar does not have any permanent discharge, but Mansar is primarily fed by the surface runoffs and partially by the mineralized water through the paddy fields, and the flow inflow increases in the rainy season. 23. Somoruri, Jammu and Kashmir. A freshwater to brackish lake lying at 4595 meters above the sea level with wet meadows and borax laden the wetland along the shores. The site is said to be represent the only breeding ground outside of China for one of the most endangered cranes, the black-necked crane, and the only breeding ground for bar-headed geese in India. So, it's the most important breeding ground for two bird species, that is black-necked crane and bar-headed geese. 24. Upper Ganga River, Uttar Pradesh. A shallow river stretch of great Ganges with intermittent small stretches of deep water pools and reservoirs upstreams from the barrages. The river provides habitat for the IUCN Red Listed Ganges River Dolphins. Please remember Ganges River Dolphins, which are blind and only river dolphins found in India, and it is also recognized as National Aquatic Animal. And Garia, so it is a type of crocodile, but their nose is longer and different from the other crocodile. So I am drawing the difference between the gharial and crocodile. So their nose looks like this. So this is the normal crocodile nose. Crocodile nose, which is literally a triangular in shape. But coming to the gharial, the nose of gharial is elongated. Longer snout is seen in gharial crocodiles. 6 species of turtles, otters, and 82 species of fishes, and more than 100 species of birds. 25. Vembanad Coal Wetlands, Kerala. The largest lake of Kerala, spanning across Alappuzha, Kottayam, and Ernakulam districts. The famous tourist locations like Alappuzha and Kumarakom are known for houseboats. River mouths of Pamba and Achankovil rivers in the Vembanad forms one of the unique wetland topography of Kerala. It is a below sea level and is famous for exotic fish varieties and paddy fields that are below sea levels. 26. Ular Lake, Jammu and Kashmir. The largest freshwater lake in India. Please remember, Ular Lake is the largest freshwater lake in India. with extensive marshes of imminent and floating vegetations, particularly water chestnuts. Please remember, particularly water chestnuts, that provides an important source of revenue for the state government and the fodder for domestic livestock. The lake supports an important fishing industry and is a valuable source of water for irrigation and domestic use. The area is important for wintering, staging and breeding birds. Please do subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thank you.